Hey guys, good morning and welcome to another episode of Behind the Closed Doors. Today, another day in our LoomCube tour. So join us for today's episode of Behind the Closed Doors. If you like what we do, subscribe to our channel, leave comments below, and of course smash that like button. But most of all, tell other people about it. Oh, and by the way, can you believe it? Brian is 21 today. Time flies. So happy birthday, Brian, if you see this. And, well, we'll be back home as soon as possible. Let's go, guys. Okay, we arrived in Almelo at Camera Express 1 hour before the show. Today, Nadine is our model, and the cool thing about these Loom Cubes is that they're actually really small, so they will always fit your bag. The thing is, however, a lot of people don't realize how much cool stuff you can do with those Loom Cubes. So today we're going to do at least 2 setups. So I'm going to start with a seminar about what we do with the Loom Cubes, and then we're going to do a live shoot. And the thing is, it's only three and a half hours, and I have to do a seminar, live shoot, and the people have to shoot themselves. So it's a little bit of a rushed seminar, but still, it's we try to give as much as attention as possible to everybody. So it's going to be a worthwhile experience, and the Loom Cubes are always cool. So let's go inside, set up, and do the Loom Cube demo. Okay, we are here in the demo studio, and the first thing we had to do is actually remove some power plugs because they were fluorescent tubes and they emit, of course, a lot of light. And today we're working with Loom Cubes, and although the Loom Cubes are incredibly bright, they're not that bright that they can actually overpower, for example, a fluorescent tube. Or they can, but I really like to have that high contrast look in my images, and at that point I don't want a lot of extra lighting. So that's why we removed the fluorescent tubes. So always make sure that you're on time when you do something. Okay, I will be using one of the smaller backdrops from Click Prop Backdrops. And these backdrops are absolutely amazing. They're really good quality and they hang pretty tight, as you can see here, even on a background system. Now, if you hang them against the wall, they're even better, but I love shooting with these. The main advantage of this backdrop is actually that it's available in different sizes. So normally when you use a backdrop, it's one size. And often I find that when I use the other backdrops, they're really awesome, but I always use them horizontally because vertically, I don't have enough space to shoot my model that way. These backdrops, because they're so big, they're actually designed to be shot with 3/4 bodies or full body models. This is a smaller one, and this one is just absolutely amazing for portraits. So I really like the way that they literally store them in tubes and that they hang pretty flat. And that's something that I found in a lot of other backdrops, that they don't hang perfectly flat, and this one does. So I highly recommend them. That's also, by the way, why we brought the product into the Netherlands, because since I think 2 or 3 months, we're the distributor in the Netherlands for these backdrops. So if you want one of those backdrops, make sure to drop any week a mail. But they're awesome. I'll be doing the presentation and the photo shoot to the iPad Pro, as you can see here. So we're using a Hyper to connect everything to a big screen TV, as you can see here. And the iPad Pro works flawlessly at the moment. The only thing is, sometimes the wireless connection from the Sony, it's a little bit flaky. So we're waiting for the TeraTools software and, of course, hardware to be released. And at that point, shooting wireless with the Sony should be a breeze. I'm now using the internal app. And although it works great in most cases, sometimes when there's a lot of Wi-Fi interference or metal or other stuff, it just doesn't work 100% perfectly. It takes a long time to take the images into the iPad. It's not unworkable, but it's very frustrating. But when it works, it's a really cool solution. And that's why we're waiting for the Tether Tool solution, because that way we have way more powerful antennas. And, well, the transfer should be a lot better. So, I'm almost ready. We still have about 5 minutes left. So, I'm ready for it. Okay guys, that was another LoomCube demo, and those little LoomCubes, they're absolutely amazing. Now we arrived home and look at this. My parents are probably visiting for Brian's birthday. So, 21. So we have a lot of decorations in. Okay guys, that was it for today. If you like what we do, please subscribe to our channel, leave comments below, smash that like button. But most of all, tell other people about it. See you again next time. Bye bye.